Welcome to Connection Kids Online. I'm Mr. Trevor, and I'm so glad you're here today. We're going to wrap up our series this week on how God is so powerful that He always comes out on top. He always comes out victorious, and how He's always there to help us. Sometimes when we think of powerful people, we might think of characters like Superman or Iron Man, Batman and Spider-Man, maybe others. Maybe we think about pro athletes or people like President. So who do you think the most powerful person in the world is? Yeah, those are some pretty powerful people, but the reality is there's no one in the world that's even close to as powerful as God is. And today we'll look at a time where God's power was on display yet again. Before we get into that, let's check out our Bible verse one last time.
Our memory verse for this series is Joshua 1:9. Have we not commanded you, be strong and courageous, do not be afraid, do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. Have I not commanded you, be strong and courageous, do not be afraid, do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. All right, everyone, let's learn some motions to this verse. Have I not commanded you, be strong and courageous, do not be afraid, do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. Have I not commanded you, be strong and courageous, do not be afraid, do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go.
Times are tough for God's people.
Times are tough for us, God's people.
Over and over, the Israelites had turned away from God. Eventually, the whole kingdom fought itself and split into two separate countries.
I don't like you.
I don't like you either. I'm making my own country. I'll be called Israel, up here in the north.
Fine, then I'll go by Judah, down here in the south.
Not only did God's people turn away from each other, but they often turned away from God. God's people became weaker and weaker.
We don't feel very strong or powerful right now.
As God's people grew weak, their enemies would attack them. Without God's strength, they would lose to their enemies. One of these enemies was the kingdom of Aram.
Have you heard? The northern kingdom of Israel is very weak right now.
It's the perfect time to attack.
Oh, wise king, where should we send the army?
Right here.
Even though they were not faithful to God, He still loved and cared for His people. God is everywhere and hears everything. He listened in on the king's plans and would tell the prophet Elisha where Aram would attack. Then, Elisha warned the king of Israel, and Israel's army was always prepared for Aram's attacks.
The Israelites had their defenses prepared. We lost.
No way! Okay, let me see. Let's attack there.
Once again, as the army of Aram approached the secret battle location, God had warned His people and they were prepared. What?
They were prepared. We lost again.
How could they be ready for our surprise attack?
The king of Aram had an idea. One of his officers must be a traitor who was warning the Israelites so they could prepare.
One of you must be a traitor who was warning the Israelites so they could prepare.
No, Your Majesty. We don't like to lose. We heard there was a prophet in Israel named Elisha.
The officers told the king that God Himself would tell Elijah his secrets, even the things the king said in his own bedroom.
God tells Elijah the things you say in your own bedroom.
So, the king of Aram decided that Elisha would be his next target.
Well then, the next place to attack is the city of Dothan, where Elijah is.
Aram's army surrounded the city of Dothan, where Elisha lived. Elisha's servant saw them early in the morning and told Elisha all about it.
There's an army surrounding the town. What can we do?
But Elisha told him not to be afraid. Those who are with us are more than those who are with them.
We have more people with us than they have in their army.
Elisha's servant looked very confused. There were so many soldiers surrounding them. How could they have more than the enemy?
Elijah, We definitely do not have more with us.
Elisha calmly prayed for God to open the servant's eyes. The servant looked up and gasped, and that's when something wonderful happened. God made it so the servant could see the mighty angels who were protecting them.
Whoa! God's army is all around us. I see horses, angels, and chariots of fire covering the hillside.
God's mighty army made a ram's army look small and weak.
God is good, and he is protecting us. Now let's get to work.
Elisha prayed that God would make a ram's soldiers go blind. And God did. He can do anything. Elisha came out to a ram's soldiers and told them that they were in the wrong place.
You're in the wrong place. Let me help you get to where you should be.
Elisha led a ram's army through the nation of Israel, right into the capital city of Samaria. When they arrived there, Elisha prayed for God to open their eyes.
Oh no! We're surrounded by Israel's troops! We're going to die!
So, Elisha, what should we do? Should we kill them all?
No, no. Let's show them kindness. Let's give them food and water, and let them go home.
Sounds great. Let's have a feast.
So, the king of Israel gave the soldiers a feast and sent them away. When the soldiers returned to Aram, the king stopped planning attacks on the Israelites. Perhaps he realized what Elisha's servant realized when he saw the angel army. God is powerful.
Worshiping is a way that we can connect with God and honor Him. When we worship, we are showing Him how thankful we are for Him and that His love for us never ends. So let's all stand up together now and worship and reach out to God and thank Him for loving us with all of our voices.
Ruth 1:16 says, "Where you go, I will go. Where you stay, I will stay. Your people will be my people, and your God, my God." All your ways are good, all your ways are sure. I will trust in you alone, higher than my sight, high above my life. Trust in you alone, in you alone. Where you go, I'll go. Where you stay, I'll stay. When you move, I'll move. I will follow you. Who you love, I love. How you serve, I'll serve. If this life I lose, I will follow you.
My hand. hands to do your work, and I give you my feet to go your way. I give you my eyes to see as you see, and I give you my tongue to speak your words. My life is in your hands, and Lord, I will follow you all of my days.
Wait a second. The king of Aram was continually attacking Israel and failing. He was losing continually. But they were failing because God was using the prophet Elisha to tell the king of Israel what the king of Aram's plan was so they could defend themselves. So what did the king of Aram do? Well, he came up with a plan. He decided he was going to attack Elisha's town and he would kill or capture Elisha. And Elisha wasn't worried? Sounds kind of crazy, right? He's surrounded by an army that wants to kill him or capture him. And he tells his servant, calm down. Everything's gonna be okay. What? You see, Elisha knew that God was with him and that God would protect him. He knew that God was even more powerful than an entire army. And God did protect him. See, God made the entire army from Aram go blind. Then Elisha led them to Samaria where they would be surrounded by the Israelite army. Talk about a change in events. But instead of destroying that army, Elisha told the king they should give them food and water and send them back home. You see, God showed his power by defeating an entire army without anyone dying. And Elisha showed them mercy just like God shows us mercy by actually taking care of them and convincing the king to give them food and water and send them back home. And after that, the king of Aram, well, he stopped planning attacks on Israel. You see, we see God's mighty power on display here, and that same power from the story that's still available to us today. So let's pray now and thank God for all he has done and given us and thank him for his mighty power. Dear God, thank you for being so powerful and for always wanting the best for us. Your power is big enough to create a universe of swirling galaxies, yet small enough to touch each of our hearts. Draw us closer to you through your Holy Spirit. Reveal yourself to us. We're eager to hear your voice. We thank you and we love you. In Jesus' name, amen. Guys, the appearance of an angel army in God's big story shows that things are not always as they seem. And though Elisha was surrounded, God was in control. Similarly, Jesus' death on the cross looked like a sure defeat. It appeared that the enemy had won. But again, things were not as they seem. You see, through his death on the cross and his resurrection, Jesus broke the power of sin and death, and the final victory belongs to him. God is always with us when things seem hopeless and we don't feel there's a way out. God is that way out. God is there with us. We see time and time again in the Bible where God helps his people or saves his people. There's many, many stories about that we can read in the Bible, God helping his people, saving his people, rescuing his people, and through those stories we can learn to trust and follow God more and more. We can also pray and talk to God and ask him to lead us and to help us follow him, and he will give us the Holy Spirit to help us do that. And we can also worship him and show him how much we love and appreciate him. Guys, it doesn't matter what you're going through, we can remember that God is always with us and he never ever leaves us alone. God is more powerful than anyone or anything in the world. So may our all-powerful God guide us and protect us as we give him our hearts and walk with him today and every day of our lives. Boys and girls, I'm so glad we could be together today. We love you and we're praying for you right here at Connection Kids. Have a great week.